Demon not being on this team anymore hurts. And even when Demon was on this UCF team, they still had their struggles.
They were not infallible.
No, they, I mean, they were a team that a lot of us thought, okay, they should be contending for a number one, number two spot. Like, they should be able to hang with the best with that kind of roster, but they got in their own way too often. And so you never really felt like they were ever going to get over that hump. Bambi's been a nice addition, but he's not the same kind of X factor that Demon was so far, at least.
You know, and the best part about it is now that we've arrived at game time, we get to just watch and see what happens and see if Sean continues to do good things or if Daz will indeed prove himself right and make us look like idiots, you know. All I know is that I've got the guy who's currently at the top of the prediction list on my side. That's all I know.
I wasn't going to say anything about it, but thank you. I think you're totally right about Sean, though, except for that whiff right there.
Yeah, we were talking about that.
Yeah, but his midfield game especially, like when we were casting them last week, I think it was with you, where he just wouldn't lose the challenge in midfield, yeah. And he started a lot of good pushes for USF.
Dude was a monster for sure, and ooh, a little ugly here from the Bulls on defense. A lot of missed touches that they need to clean up, and Bang are going to do just that.
Now, Snipes has a little bit of time to figure out his approach here, and he will find Bambi off the side wall. Nope. A good idea to push the ball forward, and UCF will push to the blue half. How will they create pressure? Bits trying to harass the back line with Banger. Right, they're having to work for their food in midfield, though they are finding these clears off the backboard. No shot's going to come
yet.
It's delayed, and Snipes too light of a shot. Banger had no boost. He jumped up and hoped that Snipes gave him a ball like that.
All right, sub for you got to start hitting the ball on defense or else you're going to get scored on here. you can't keep missing. You're playing with fire, and that's a very welcome clear from Sean. Now it's just, okay, we're out. Let's stay out.
Have control of midfield now with Feenster. You know, Feenster just end up giving up the ball to Bambi, and, you know, game ones, they usually start like this, right?
Yeah, everyone warm up. You know, it must have been a long day in the classroom today, guys.
Oh, Sean. Benefactor of the rotation there. The ball popping right off of his car. And a couple of eventful moments so far, but none that USF would like to be the receiving end of. Bambi throwing another free one ball down center, but that's just going to give the ball up back to Feenster.
Nice pass. And well done, Snipes.
Oh, and Sean again. Yeah, Bits would have had a breakaway right in front of the box. That shot just off the crossbar, and Snipes can't find it off the corner. Bits, another shot. He'll find it finally. UCF on the board.
There we go, Bits. Well done. Be patient here. Yeah, Snipes probably should have scored it, but to be honest, that's still good enough. It just puts a little more pressure on Bits to hit a nice shot, and he does. The patience and the spacing really valuable there. And again, South Florida, a couple of misses on defense, but that's okay. I think going forward in the series, they're definitely going to settle in and reset themselves here. Oh, Bambi missing two.
Ooh. That's going to give a breakaway for Sean and Feenster. Bits up for it. And Sean getting the bump.
Oh, he got the block.
Disaster on the box. And Feenster gets another challenge. We'll steal the boost on top of it. Will USF create something out of this? They have a favorable rotation, winning that touch from Sean, but nobody's ready for that pass.
Straight across that box. I think Banger was expecting something a little more angled to come out towards him, and that hard cut just didn't give him enough time to get back over. Feenster off the wall. Sean a little too tight. Dips it down for Banger, and he's just going to peel off to reset a different angle. Snipes is covering the near post, and Sean's going to have to play defense there just because he knows he's not going to be able to beat Bambi to that one. USF a decent push there for the Bulls, but just a little uncoordinated. Need to solidify what they're going to do with those touches beforehand.
Yeah, the touch that they expect to get out to a teammate, or the one they expect a shot to happen, both of their teammates are ending up having to go get boost. But you like how they form up on the defensive half. They have quick transitions, rarely give up the ball like they did right there, and trying to develop a three-point passing play, but Banger rotated high and around. Sean has a shot, and USF coming around the corner.
Well, they almost gave up a goal on their own half, but then they just turned it into, I think it was four touches. The clear, the pass out to the side, one off the wall, and that last one from Sean. And they ended up tying it up in 0 seconds. I think it was Bits who came up empty on that ball over his shoulder off the backboard, and right there for it, finally, a Bull.
Yeah, but that the transition game again for USF, like ever since those first pushes, basically right after UCF scored, they didn't allow a lot of freebies off the backboard, and they've been able to get out of the blue half pretty quickly. Sean going to push forward again, but nothing to do with the ball as Bambi takes over.
Oh, great challenge.
Oh, Bitts by himself, but can at least buy some time, maybe even create an opportunity now with Bambi on the backside. Not a lot of room to work with for either team, but UCF slowly inch their way forward. Banger, excellent job around the corner on defense, and gets a pass out to Feedster downfield. Ooh. He's got the shot blocked in midair. Oh, that was a close one.
Ooh, Bambi, very well done. You thought for a second they caught out the Knights. And Sean, that's a very favorable kickoff. Bits in a bad spot. Bambi has to hit the brakes, and Banger's going to just pop it over his head. South Florida going to win game one.
That's about as perfect of an opportunity for UC or for USF as you can get. Bits rushed that off the corner.
He
it looked
to.
Like he was expecting the challenge. And yeah, like you said, you expect him to make that touch. It never comes, and Bits looks silly as he flies off.
Exactly. Bits had to defend that touch. That he was expecting the shot to come from that ball. I think it was Sean who was chasing that one down out of the midfield, but that's really just a kickoff gone wrong there in overtime for the Knights. It wasn't anything, you know, like awful. They didn't really make a mistake. It was just that initial challenge kind of popped that ball over the man who was following up behind the initial kickoff, and unfortunately for them, they just had a great read on that bounce off the sidewall, and Bits had to defend the shot. They came up empty, and the follow-through was right there for it, so South Florida... Gonna be honest, it looked a little ugly on defense there in game one. It was not pretty.
Yeah.
They gave up a lot of free opportunities, but they kept themselves in it. And that's what we always talk about. If you're not gonna play particularly well, if you're only down by one, you're still in it.
Well, you know, Achieves on the other scorecard. It's currently you and I 1 and Daz 0. So, you know, as we count down the match here. But USF, it might have looked rocky at the start, but hey. Rocket League is you're only as good as your last challenge kind of game. So even if the first minute didn't work out for you, you square up, you clean it up, and no one will notice. Oh, Feedster dumped down to Sean. That's really good touch out. And Bambi will be able to clear it out. But those types of touches from USF have been so dangerous. Banger, happy that ball bounces off the crossbar. But this is Bambi's ball, full tank of boost. Underneath, flip reset, just goes underneath. Can't squeeze it between Feedster.
I actually really like Bambi's idea to try and take that down to the floor, because since he's so close to the net there, popping that up into the air dribble, obviously he's going to make the defense freeze on the goal line. He sees no one's coming to get him. And so allowing that ball to come back down gives him even more options. If they give him a little more space, maybe he can hit that flip reset into the top of the net. But he felt comfortable enough to go for that ground pinch. It really didn't amount to much because the defense covered it quite nicely, but... If you're ever going to just pop one into an air dribble at the defensive end, I mean, go for it like Bambi did. That was brilliant.
Right, you talk about, you know, being replacing Demon and trying to be that type of X-Factor for his team. That's the type of gameplay that Demon gave UCF in the past, is that mechanical style that gives you so many options. Bambi tried to set up Bits, but Feenster can play the ball away.
When Feenster has a little bit of extra space, I think Snipes... Probably should have went for the challenge there, but either way, Feenster wasn't able to make a good follow-up touch. Sean with the speed. Feenster just needs to pop this over Bits, and indeed, it's going to be just under the bar. USF out in front.
Wow. USF quick one here from Sean. Gets over two defenders. Feenster cutting around, and Bits tries to cut around quickly on that one, and that's just a really tough spot to be in. You have both of your teammates ending up past the ball. You have to rotate back quickly, and your timing, you basically have to see the future if you're Bits in that situation. You're lower on boost, you're not already in position, and Feenster's got advantage. Well done by USF on the turnaround. But that wasn't without some good pressure from UCF. They just couldn't convert.
Yeah, it was Sean making those big challenges in the midfield to break that up. Snipes trying to get one back and off the post. Bambi to play follow-up on the wall, and let's see how many options he creates this time. Again with a flip reset, and look how quick Banger went out there to close that gap. That's exactly how you want to defend it. You see him pop it up, get in their face as quick as you can. Oh, things just caught out.
Yep, but he'll get to it. Ooh. He was expecting Banger to make that touch, and he was sitting on low boost, too. Another challenge right up to the ceiling, but Banger making it happen.
Wow.
Hey, man, boost is a crutch for Banger.
gave himself those follow-up opportunities, despite being in definitely an awkward spot, to say the least. Beanster, yep, give it up. Run away, just block Bambi's clear. That's exactly what he does. Sean, that aggression, trying to tie things up in midfield.
Still a nice series of challenges. And Sean giving that a better look for Feenster.
Oh, second ball for Sean here. Yep.
Oh, he just nailed that against the backboard and got the second read, but that might have just given UCF a way out. And Bitt pushes the ball downfield. Yeah.
Oh, they might catch Bambi here. It's a race back the other way. Look at him, just able to get that over. Sean trying to get on the outside of the ball, and UCF dangerously close to conceding that insurance goal. Do be careful.
Clear still looking good from USF, too. Sean, another great challenge, and Feenster just missed the net. Just off the ramp, Snipes will play it out, but this is a good push now again for USF for that all-important insurance.
Now, here's the thing you really got to go back and wonder about pending the results of this game. Do USF win or lose? If they do lose, they know that they absolutely should have won this one. They could have three goals by now at this point with how many open nets they've missed.
Definitely. Yeah, you got to make sure you keep UCF out at all costs. You can't turtle up on defense. One little slip up can make all of those opportunities you missed come back into your headspace, but Banger forces two to commit, and now Sean's got time. Oh, and his time's gone as Snipes whip back around to steal the ball. Another good look for Feenster. It pumped it back over to the right side. The challenge is getting a little more difficult, but Banger gets all of that one. A little more boost to follow. USF hanging on to this ball. They've killed so much time on the clock on this possession, but they need to kill all of it.
Exactly. That's the hard part right now. Oh, but that challenge from Bambi's going to help. He went for the pinch and just missed it. He hit it the wrong way. And look at how much extra time they get to waste now. Almost a full 20 seconds because Bambi made one bad touch.
But still, they're moved down forward. And Sean flips back into the ball for the save. Tough read. Feenster gets the next challenge. No chance for Bitts to hang on to midfield. Another push here for USF, or one more transition for the Knights. Well, Bitts will see this one. Pass to Bambi, and he missed the ball. Sean had it covered regardless. And Banger gets the challenge out. Here comes one more for UCF. But Snipes is just trying to buy time for Bitts and Bambi. Here comes a catch from Banger. Bitts can't find the ball. Neither can Bambi. Feenster, no chance. Snipes gets the clear out. Here comes Bambi down the field for UCF. But Sean, another crucial touch. Bitts shot too high. Sean has the catch. Sean kills the ball. USF, one to go.
Talk about starving out a clock. Yeah, they had to stave off a couple of pushes from UCF, but that last minute was just brilliant from South Florida in terms of stalling out a game. You want to talk about a slugfest? Shots to three.
That didn't really feel like it, did it?
Talk about fighting for a ball in the corner for 5 minutes.
That's true. That did happen. You're right. But like, there were also a lot of clean transitions, too. I thought like USF had a lot of sick pushes. UCF had some good ones. I think just the struggle for me with UCF is that they just don't have an offense. They don't play as a team on offense. There's no passing. There's, okay, we'll play it off the back wall, the backboard. Well, there's no philosophy of trying to find each other in the blue half at all.
That's the big shortage, because you're absolutely right. Because you saw Bambi with a couple of opportunities there out in front of the net. All he needs is, if he's got any other option other than just himself, any outlet pass or something like that, UCF's probably going to score a lot more. It's just a matter of UCF being in position at the right time. Because, yes, you can make the key block and keep the pressure going, but if your teammates aren't there to follow up, it's not going to matter. Sean to Banger, and that's right towards the top of the net. Second opportunity off the crossbar as well. Snipes going to roll one straight down the middle for Feenster. Bambi's in an awkward spot, and thankfully, that is a quality touch out into the corner.
Now, what a start for USF on offense. To really put the exclamation point on, they got to punch this one in, and Sean almost does, but it's right into Snipes. And now USF forced back. UCF, they've got a ton of looks in the blue half, but they've just been slower than that guy. Sean has been so fast in between the thirds for USF, and Bambi be able to punch that ball out.
Feenster was trying to get inside Bambi's brain there, see if he could just pull off a fake and throw off Bambi's line. As he was going for that challenge, Bitts one-on-one, and open net, Bitts cuts him down.
Finally, a goal for UCF after so many pushes that came up fruitless. Feenster got caught out hard.
That was ugly.
Yeah.
He had no boost in the tank, and he decided to take the long cut towards the ball. He was rotating out towards the other side, probably to get boost, and then realized he was probably going to have to play defense. And instead of just hedging his bets with zero boost in net, tried to make himself big and just got beat.
Very few times has a long cut actually afforded a defender more time or a better look at the attacking player.
What is that?
And more times than I could count has a whiff off the backboard led to an easy goal for South Florida.
Hang on. Did Bambi and... Nope, Snipes missed it, and Bambi missed it. They both just didn't quite have the boost to get there. They're both on zero as they're approaching that ball.
Banger's nuts. He threaded the needle on the backboard.
Literally. That's the only place that was going to work.
Ooh, Bits, hard push. And like I said, I like how UCF pushed down the field. Like, I like their transition game. But then when it comes to hanging on to midfield, like, they always have to go back to their own corner and always have to fight for way more length than they probably wish they would have. And I think that's why both you and I really struggled to pick them in this match and why we lean more towards USF, because of that lack of consistency on offense for me, but I'm sure for you in other areas as well. But this is kind of where push comes to shove for me personally, as USF pushed down the field.
That may be true, but that being said, these have still been one-goal games all the way throughout for UCF, and
fair.
I really just feel like it just takes a few tightening of the screws, some more people in position, a little more boost conscious, and just like that, they can be all over you. But they might have caught Bambi there. It's just high. Sean's going to float one out into the middle for Feenster. Banger trying to take it away from Bits, and they're going to have to scramble back.
Ooh, Banger getting back there, makes the touch, and almost got it perfectly. Feenster in a bad spot. Bits plays it away again. UCF do not want to put this ball back in front of a blue car. Pass in front. That Sean gets
smart,
in the way
actually.
Of Feenster turns back hard and across the post picks up the next save. But UCF aren't done. Pass in front. Feenster gets it away before he's deleted.
It was the right choice from Sean to go and pop that off his own backboard. He knew he could beat the offensive players, even if it meant pulling a couple of his teammates out of position there. Much better for you to hit it off the backboard there than allow a potential challenger get beat.
I thought that pinch off the corner was going into the net.
I
was on Banger's car, and I just saw the angle. I was like, that's just going to bounce off the crossbar and in, but it didn't. Still, UCF now struggling on defense to get this ball out. Sean right in front of him. USF happy to push as far into orange territory as they can. Well, they might have to wait here as Bits pushes down the field, but Banger gets in the way of it too. Oh, he missed.
Missed
the ball. You cannot miss those at this level, or Sean is going to put the ball in the back of the net.
Oh, you know why he missed it? I went to his camera. He hits the brakes right before he jumps. Takes away a lot of that momentum, and it just makes that takeoff a little weird. Oof.
That's funny, too, because, like, don't you feel like more times than not hitting the brakes is a good thing to try to
in
get
general,
a solid launch, right?
Yeah.
But that you want that momentum.
He needed it going a certain way, and he just stalled it out just enough. Banger misses a clear. Bits with a chance to put one into the right, left-hand side of the net. Excuse me, Sean able to clear it out. And now we enter into a very similar scenario as to last game, where you got to waste about 90 seconds off the clock if you're South Florida, and you come out 3-0 sweep.
Yeah, USF are playing kind of nuts in this game. Sean picks up that save off the backboard. Feenster's there already. The speed on defense was something that they were struggling with earlier in the match, but that's gone. Sean, perfect challenge.
Ooh.
Perfect win against Bits, and had he not gotten demoed, he might have been able to force the ball in front of the box.
One third of the way home, and look at that. Another big block from Sean. Bits, you cannot afford to miss, and yep, that's his only play. Feenster just trying to get the ball back out into the middle. Banger to Feenster. Feenster for Sean. It's going to be a stretch.
Ooh.
Bambi's too late. It's punched
oh.
off the post. That one's kicked aside. What a save from Bambi.
Oh, and Banger just wasn't patient enough. He only had 15 boost in the tank, so he wanted to drive up quickly to grab a rebound fast enough, but too committed on the UCF line. Hang on
ooh,
a second.
He's going for it!
Get out your protractors, ladies and gentlemen. This angle's ridiculous.
Oh, I saw Feenster up there on the back wall, and I was thinking, all right, do you go for the shot? Are you trying to drop it down to Sean? And Feenster, feeling confident, spikes one into the ground, into the net. What a shot.
that was some good stuff. UCF now pushed against the ropes here. How can they respond with 20 seconds remaining? Bambi back over to Snipes. Bitz has to stay back. Feenster couldn't get a solid touch, but Sean trying to get that clear out. He doesn't have it. Well, now he does. Back over to Feenster. USF playing with purpose in this match against UCF. A quick passing play is denied by Sean. Bitz tries to push it forward, but it's all for naught. South Florida put up a 3-0 spot onto UCF and almost a fourth goal to boot.
As Dez would say, Snipes, if you don't win today, he's apparently never going to hear the end of it for the rest of the season. And all I got to say to Dez is I'm not going to let you hear the end of it for the rest of the season either now, buddy.
And I can confirm to Snipes that Dez will not let you hear the end of it for the rest of the season. He's very good at that. So, enjoy that one. But UCF, the struggles do continue for this team where they're starting to fall a little bit farther than I think a lot of people were expecting, especially with Bambi. I know that we've made the Bambi to Demon, comparison a couple times over, and it's really not to Bambi's detriment at all. It's just Demon was a certain type of player that gave the Knights opportunities.
A lot
of
pressure. Yeah.
Yeah, that they're just not getting with Bambi. And Bambi's a much more control type player. Demon was a very first
fast,
killer type
face,
player, right?
Bam.
Yeah,
bam,
exactly.
Bam.
Exactly. Well, guess what? We got plenty more CRL action coming up for you guys after the break. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.